Dear students, we were discussing about equilibrium, the equilibrium concentration and the law of mass action. So today's tutorial is also about the Kc value, that how you will write down the Kc value for a reaction. Such type of small questions, short questions are asked in paper, in matric class, in first year chemistry, that an equation or reaction has been given, you have to write down the Kc value for this type of reaction. So remember, the Kc value is equal to the product of the molar concentration of products divided by the product of the molar concentration of reactants. I have written it in the red, that products in square brackets shows the molar concentration of the products divided by reactants in square brackets, which shows the molar concentration of reactants. Let's suppose the reaction between hydrogen and iodine. If this type of reaction is given in paper, hydrogen reacts with iodine and it forms hydrogen iodide. The question will be asked that write down the Kc value or equilibrium constant expression for this reaction. So you will write down that Kc is equal to the molar concentration of products divided by the molar concentration of reactants. So the molar concentration of products is Hi raised to power 2 divided by the product of reactants, that is hydrogen and iodine. So this is the equilibrium expression for this reaction. Normally this type of questions are asked in short question carrying 2 marks or 3 marks. So you have to write down the Kc value in this way. Now there is a simple thing, that whenever there are solids involved in the reaction or pure liquids are involved in the reaction, so the concentration of the solids and the concentration of the liquids always remains constant, and the concentration of solid and liquid will be ignored in the Kc value. Generally, I have written a common example involving the solid. That is, when calcium carbonate dissociate, it decomposes to form calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Now, the physical states are important in order to be written in the equilibrium reactions, because they will be shown in the Kc value or they will not be shown in the Kc value. It depends upon their physical states. As I have mentioned, that the concentration of solids and the concentration of pure liquids will remain constant while writing down the Kc value for this reaction. Now the calcium carbonate decomposes and it forms calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. By writing the Kc value for this reaction, the molar concentration of the products divided by the molar concentration of the reactants. So calcium oxide multiplied by carbon dioxide is a numerator, and calcium carbonate will be in the denominator. Now, as I have mentioned, that the concentration of solids and the concentration of pure liquids remain constant. So in this case, calcium oxide is present in the solid form, calcium carbonate is also present in the solid form, so they will be ignored when you are writing the Kc value for this reaction. So for this type of reaction, the Kc value will only be equal to the concentration of carbon dioxide. That is, Kc is equal to carbon dioxide, but as carbon dioxide is present in the gaseous form, so the Kc will be replaced for this reaction by Kp, because it shows the partial pressure and the molar concentration, which were shown in the square brackets, that will now be replaced by P. So Kc for this individual reaction, particular reaction in which solids are involved, the concentration will only be equal to the molar concentration of gases. Like in this reaction, Kc is equal to carbon dioxide. Now next is, importance of Kc value. There are two importance of Kc value. One is to find out the direction of a chemical reaction, and the second one is to find out the extent of a chemical reaction. Now, the direction of a chemical reaction, by comparing Kc with KOC. Now, there are two things.
Kc is equilibrium concentration. It is the constant value for a reaction when it is at equilibrium state. And the Qc is the concentration other than equilibrium at any time. At any time you can withdraw and you can find out the value of Qc that is other than equilibrium. Now by comparing Qc and Kc, we have to detect the direction of a chemical reaction. Now the first case is when Qc is greater than Kc. So such type of reactions, they are occurring and they have crossed the equilibrium condition. A large amount of product is formed in this reaction and the Qc has been crossed. So such type of reaction will move in backward direction in order to attain the equilibrium state. So by comparing Qc and Kc, we can detect the direction of a chemical reaction. Now the second case is when Qc is less than Kc. Now Qc is less than Kc, so the equilibrium concentration is still to be achieved. Now the reaction has not yet attained the equilibrium state, so it will move in forward direction in order to attain the equilibrium concentration or equilibrium state. So for this purpose, whenever the Qc is greater than Kc, reaction will move in backward direction, and whenever the Qc is less than Kc, the reaction will move in forward direction in order to attain the equilibrium concentration. The third case is when Qc is equal to Kc. In this case, the Qc is equal to Kc, so the equilibrium concentration has been attained. So such type of reaction will move in both the direction with same rate. That is, it will move in forward direction and it will move in backward direction with the same rate, because equilibrium is already reached when Qc is equal to Kc. So equilibrium is attained. Neither the reaction will move in one direction, neither the reaction will move in second, but in both
the direction with the same rate. Now the second is extent of a chemical reaction. It again depends upon the Kc value. That if the Kc value is very high for a reaction, let's suppose when the Kc value is greater than 10^10⁻³, so it is considered to be a very high value. I have written a reaction of oxygen. That is, ozone decomposes to oxygen, it forms oxygen. For this reaction, the Kc value is equal to 10^55. It means it is very, very high value. When the Kc value is very high, so maximum amount of products is present while reactants will be less in amount. Because the Kc value is very high, so much of the concentration of reactants, they are converted into products, and at this condition maximum amount of products will be present in the equilibrium state. Now second is when Kc is too small. When Kc is too small, when the Kc value is less than 10^-3, so it is considered to be very small value. A general reaction, that is hydrogen fluoride decomposes to form hydrogen and fluorine. For this reaction, the Kc value is equal to 10^-13 at 2000°C. Now it is very, very small value. When the Kc is very small, so in this type of reaction, the amount of reactants is maximum at equilibrium state while the amount of products is minimum. Because the reaction is reached at equilibrium, but much of the reactants are not converted into products, equilibrium is achieved very early and much of the concentration of the reactants are remaining and less amount of products will be formed. When the Kc is neither too large and neither too small, it ranges from 10^-3 and it ranges between 10^-3 and 10^-3. So such type of Kc value are considered to be moderate value. These are neither too large neither too small. For a reaction in which N2O4 forms NO2, this type of reaction has the Kc value 0.36. at 25 degree centigrade. So it is neither 10 raised to the power minus or neither it is 10 raised to the power plus value, but it is between the two. So it means it is a moderate value for this type of reaction. The concentration of products and the concentration of reactants, they both are present in considerable amount. It means neither the products are maximum, neither the reactants are maximum, but both are present at a considerable amount in the reaction. So the extent of a chemical reaction and direction of a chemical reaction, they both can be found out with the help of Kc value. That's all about this chapter, and we will move towards the next chapter. Till the time, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon in order to get notification of the new videos. Thank you.